Howdy, guys, and welcome to night six of Big Brother 23, and welcome to Cliff Notes from outside the Big Brother house. All right, first of all, before we start, let me just give out a birthday greetings to Kylan. He is celebrating his birthday today. Apparently, all the house guests have a toga party planned, so we'll see if they have a little fun today to get some of the stress out from this past week. What an amazing week it's been. So let's talk about, before we do the summaries of the evening, let's talk about the veto ceremony that occurred yesterday. Originally, we had Alyssa and Kylan on the block. Well, as expected, Derek X used his veto, pulled Kylan off the block. Frenchie got up, replaced Kylan with Travis. So now we've got Travis, Alyssa on the block. Most likely, Travis is going to go home. It seems like it may not be a unanimous decision, but it should be close. It looks like Travis probably is the target. Of course, that's a couple of days from now. We'll see what happens between now and Thursday. Talk about unanimous votes versus maybe not unanimous votes. We do have a conversation going on between Derek F. and fellow Butcher Alliance members Christian and Xavier. And Derek said, hey, what if we throw some hinky votes against Alyssa just to stir things up? Really? Things haven't been confusing enough so far this week that you want to throw a few more wrenches in the equation. I get it that Derek's wanting to create some confusion about maybe who is supporting who. I do get it. But I'm not sure there's enough strong loyalties in this house right now and people trusting each other's real relationships enough that a hinky vote's going to do that much. I just think there's enough uncertainty that, yeah, people are going to wonder who cast it and all that. I don't think it's going to create that much more chaos and paranoia because we already have so much of it. But we'll see what happens. Now, you got to be careful. Derek, Christian, Xavier, if they start throwing a hinky vote, if one or two other people from some other groups throw some hinky votes as well, next thing you know, maybe you have a decision that you really hadn't planned on. So you got to be careful, but we'll see if Derek follows through with that. We did have a big meeting last night, early evening. Frenchie called a meeting of the slaughterhouse. Not real sure what the purpose was. I think it really was just to get everyone together in a room and looking each other in an eye and saying, yeah, we're in the big alliance this season. We've got to watch out for each other. He's not going to be HOH next week. We know that. So he's trying to create as much protection for himself as he can while he still has a little power by making sure everyone knows that they're committed to each other. And it just happens to include Frenchie as well. So they did have that meeting. Now, normally an 8-person alliance can really run a house through most weeks. But is this one strong enough and loyal enough to each other to do that? Personally, I don't think so. I think there's enough other alliances, side groups, things like that. I think the slaughterhouse is an alliance in name only, and the true decisions are going to be made by the smaller groups, maybe the butchers, which is a smaller group of slaughterhouse. But I think slaughterhouse, I think it's a temporary alliance in name only. I don't see it doing a whole lot or lasting for a long time through this season itself. Now, there was some flipping around a little bit with the slaughterhouse members. The final slaughterhouse, at least, is determined by who was up in this meeting. Are Frenchie, Derek F., Christian, Kylan, Xavier, Whitney, Alyssa, and Brent. So we'll see what happens as we go forward. We had a conversation a little bit later. Alyssa is talking to Brent, and she's saying, look, if I win HOH, Derek X and Hannah are going to go up. That's who I'm going to nominate. But then later she says that Hannah is one of the few girls that she has a connection with inside the house. First of all, why is she telling Brent this? I don't know that they've got a real tight connection. So why is she talking about who she may nominate? I think the reason is that she may be trying to mislead him a little bit. I think that she has a little bit of an agreement with Derek X. I'm not going to call it a final two necessarily, but I do think she's got a little bit of a connection. And so I wonder if she is just talking to Brent and strictly trying to mislead him a little bit, knowing that what she says to him very well may get back to the rest of the Slaughterhouse Alliance. And again, she's trying to make sure that no one sees her as a threat. Derek X, in a lot of people's minds, is kind of target number one in the house. And so by her saying that, she's hoping that she's developing some loyalty with some alliance members that she wants to get some support with. So we'll see what happens to that. We do have a meeting of Team Joker. Now, remember a day or two ago, The rest of the team was complaining that Frenchie wasn't really giving them enough time of the day. He was so busy with other groups. So they have a meeting of the four of them. Tiffany's in the meeting for just a little bit. She realizes this is kind of a Team Joker meeting. She gets up and leaves, and everyone's fine with that. But the Team Joker is talking. Frenchie asks the other teams, he says, look, obviously it depends on who gets HOH, but there's a lot of people who are going to be targeting me. With that in mind, depending on who wins HOH, but would y'all be willing to let me play in the wild card competition to try to win safety for myself and hopefully drag some of y'all along as well? Because he does think he's going to be a target for multiple people in that house. And he's probably right. Everyone agrees to let him go ahead and play for the wild card under the circumstances. We do have some other conversation in there. Brittany is worried. She says she works out so much in the house and she's afraid people are noticing it, that people are going to start considering her a female competition beast. Derek F., I think at that point, may be the one. I could be wrong, but someone in the group said, nah, they're not going to think that, Brittany, which is kind of a subtle dig. But Brittany is worried that she's standing out a little too much because she's working out. She does mention that if it is some kind of endurance type HOH competition, she's perfectly happy to throw it to someone else as long as it's someone that she trusts, that she feels safe with. But she's happy to let someone else take the glory and be the HOH once enough people have dropped or fallen or whatever the competition may be. And then finally, we do have it's kind of a funny comment. Derek F. is talking about saying, guys, I'm going to fight. I'm going to get mental competition, balance competition, throwing a ball, hitting stuff, whatever it is, I'm going to give it 100%. I'm going to fight for this HOH. But if it's a wall endurance competition, don't count on me winning the HOH. It's all right, Derek. I don't think anyone's probably figuring that's going to be your strongest competition. It wasn't mine either. So Derek said, I'm going to give it all I've got, but just be prepared. If it's a wall competition, it ain't going to be me, guys. So we have that. A little bit later, we have a conversation going on. Kylan and Sarah are talking. These two are talking a lot, and they're sharing a lot of information. Is a showmance developing? No, I don't think so, because I seem to remember that Sarah Beth has a relationship outside the house. I think that's correct. So I don't think it'll turn into a showmance, but I do think that they're developing a lot of trust with each other, more so than I've seen with most people talking to one another. It seems like they really are staying loyal to each other, trusting each other. I kind of like seeing that. I absolutely do. I'd love to see them continue to work together. Now, Kylan did tell her during the conversation about the slaughterhouse and the butcher alliances, which Sarah Beth is not part of. And that's fine, but keep this in mind. A new alliance formed in the last 24 hours. Yeah, you couldn't have Big Brother 23 without a new alliance every few hours, right? A new alliance formed in the last 24 hours called the Jackpots, and it consists of Sarah Beth, Claire, and Tiffany. So what are the chances? Kylan just got through telling Sarah Beth about the slaughterhouse and about the butchers. What are the chances that these two alliances are now going to get back leaked back to the other Jackpot members, which are Claire and Tiffany, and then from that point get passed back on to the entire Sirens Girls Alliance? And next thing you know, all the people who aren't in the Slaughterhouse Alliance are going to be aware of it. Now, I don't know that it's a huge deep secret. The big alliances like that are tough to keep hidden, as I know, but this may make it that much easier or solidify or confirm the information. So did Kylan mess up a little bit by passing this information on to Sarah Beth? Well, perhaps so. But again, they do seem tight. It will be interesting to see if Sarah Beth passes this information on to the other women in the house. Then that may give you a little indication where her loyalties lie. If she keeps it silent, if she doesn't say anything about it or is very subtle about it, then that may show a little bit more of a connection with Kylan, which again, I would love to see. Another conversation that's going on. Azza's telling Tiffany that she'll target Brent if she's HOH. It probably won't happen because Azza has already said that she may not even try hard in the HOH, that she feels pretty safe at this point in time. And I think she's right. I really don't think anyone is targeting Azza at this point in time. She's in a good position with everyone in the house. And that was mentioned during the Team Jokers meeting. I think Derek X is the one that said, Azza, you got it made. No one is going after you. But she does tell Brent that she's going to target, or that she tells Tiffany that she'll target Brent if she's HOH. Now, that would be interesting because Frenchie and Brent supposedly have a final two with each other, supposedly are working tight together, and Frenchie is a fellow teammate of Oz's. So there could be a little friction if that was to occur. I don't think it will, but it's worth watching as well. She also mentioned Derek X and Whitney as other possible nominations. Now, Frenchie, this is funny. Frenchie asked her during the earlier, yesterday, I guess, or the night before, when he had everyone up on the balconies and such. He asked her if she would nominate, who she would nominate if she had the chance as HOH. And she told him, she said, "I don't know, but I wouldn't be changing my mind every 2 seconds like you did, Frenchie." So Ozzy knows what's going on. I think she's got a pretty strategic mind, and she's been laying low. She's not been as active in participation with some of the all the discussion back and forth. She tends to stay off to herself, goes to bed a little bit earlier. I think that's working to her advantage at this point in time. At one point, and with that in mind, at one point later last night in the backyard, everyone is out there except for Ozzy. Frenchie at one point says, "Ozzy, rest, sleep, whatever, but you need to come out tomorrow night just to be involved with everyone else." Well, eventually Ozzy does get up and comes out and participates with the rest of the house. I think that's good. It's one thing to try to not get too caught up in some of these conversations, as hectic, as pandemonium as they've been, but you also have to be involved. And so she's picked up on that. And so she's out in the backyard. They're all house guests are playing a game, lots of embarrassing stories, dating stories, one-liners, a lot of cringy one-liners. We got some players in this house. I'll just say that. We have got some players from both genders that told a lot of stories while they're in the house. It was kind of fun watching that. At a later point, Brittany later starts feeling dizzy. She's crying. She's not feeling well, to the point that a couple of people say, "Do we need to call a doctor?" And she says, no, I'm good. And she kind of hints at there may be a little medical issues and things like that. Now, I hope she's okay, and I hope that it's just one of those things. Everyone has their down days and all that. The cynic in me makes me wonder, is she exaggerating it up just a little bit? We had just a little bit earlier her conversation that she's worried she's being considered too much of a female comp beast because she works out so much. Brittany is smart enough. It would not surprise me if maybe she's playing up feeling bad just a little bit to try to get some people not thinking so much of her as a female comp beast. Just a thought. I have no evidence to verify that, confirm that. Just something that takes place in the old paranoid mind of someone who's played Big Brother. All right, another conversation that's going on. Derek X and Hannah are talking in the bedroom. She's talking about watching it, who hangs out with who in the house. Brilliant move, brilliant thing to do, because you can tell a lot just by who's in the same room, who sits next to each other at the kitchen table, things like that. Hannah's interesting. She really isn't in any alliances. She kind of is in the cookout alliance, but I'm not sure if she even knows that. But Hannah has been very much a free agent with regards to alliances, but she's obviously very observant and she's paying attention. And I think that's going to pay off in the long run. I've heard her name mentioned a few times as targets, but not because she's a threat, but just because there's some people I think that just think she's someone they could potentially put on the block without getting a lot of blood on her hands. So she may need to be a little careful, but I think if she can make it through the next few weeks, she's observant enough. I think she's going to do pretty well. All right. We have a conversation. Frenchie talking about wanting to backdoor Derek X. What is the deal with backdoors this season? I get it. You go after the people that you think are the huge, strong comp beast. Does Derek fit that category? Now, he did win the veto, so there is that to be said, but it seems like some people are very focused on backdoors this season. Yes, I get it. You make it easier or harder for that person to compete, to protect themselves, but in backdooring, it also means that three people are on the block that week instead of two. It's just that much more blood on your hands. I think you have to be very careful with that, to Frenchie and everyone else who keeps talking about backdoors. Finally, we've got Brent and Derek X at the hammock. Brent is saying that there could be an all-girls alliance. He's not sure, but they don't have the numbers, even if there is. Well, here's the thing. You don't have to necessarily have the majority just to exert a lot of influence. The all-girls alliance, yeah, there aren't eight that'll be voting together because the teams have kind of split people enough to keep that from happening. But the girls alliance, if they do continue to work together, they still have enough people in there that they could influence some of the votes that occur, control what's happening until they do have enough numbers to represent a decent majority. So Brent better be careful and keep an eye out and not discount this alliance too much. Brent's also saying that he got close to Frenchie over the past few days only because he was a potential target and he had to be careful, but that now he's really going to be watching Frenchie and make some decisions about whether he trusts Frenchie or doesn't trust Frenchie, whether he works with him, et cetera. He's going to be watching Frenchie this coming week. I think a lot of people are going to be doing that, don't you? But he's going to be watching. Is Brent playing both sides? Probably so. He's developing as many relationships as many ways as he could. So I get it. But yeah, Frenchie and Brent supposedly have a final two, but like so many alliances in the house right now, it may not be worth the paper it's written on, or in this case, not written on, but we'll see. We just don't know what's true right now. It'll take time to hash that out. And with that in mind, and let's close with this. Brent mentions that he isn't sure of anyone's true loyalties because this week was so messy. I absolutely agree. Everyone promising everything to everyone. We need to go over one of these days of the alliances. I need more than 15 minutes. I need several hours to talk about the alliances. Everyone's aligned with everyone else. And Brent's right. It's been too messy. We don't know who really is loyal to each other until we get a few more people on the block and see how votes go, things like that. So it'll happen. It just hasn't happened yet this week. Guys, y'all have a fantastic day. I'll see y'all again tomorrow. Cheers, my friends. SKD 143. Bye.